Here's what you missed on Phathead and Cande in the morning. Weekdays 6 to 10 a.m. on My Country 96.1.
My Country 96.1, Phathead, Cande, Roth, 86, hot, humid, clouds, then turning to sun this afternoon. Cande?
What? Yes. Nothing.
Yes, you are right. You are right. You've got the weather correct. Cande, we have a few things. Of course, we'll get into national days and good news and some other things going on. I did want to mention this story, and it makes me fear for the future of this country, Cande.
All right.
So I'm reading this story about these employees of the Taco Bell in Nashville. Have you seen the story about?
I have not.
Okay. Last Monday, just after the 4th of July, it was July 5th, as a matter of fact, the employees at a Taco Bell down in Nashville thought it would be a good idea to celebrate the 4th of July, Cande. In their brilliance, they decided to set off some fireworks inside the restaurant.
Oh, that's genius. That's really bright.
So it was caught on surveillance cameras. Here's what they did. They locked the place to keep customers out. They ran around the inside of the store with fireworks in their hands. They went into the men's bathroom, ignited fireworks in a trash can.
My goodness.
Then they did the same thing in a trash can in the main dining room and filmed it on their phones.
Oh, my God.
They went outside to get a better view, to take it all in, if you will.
Yeah, take it all in. That's a good one.
Ended up locking themselves out of the store. Cande?
Wow, good.
So they watched the explosions and ignited a fire in the restaurant.
Wow.
They called 911. Firefighters put it out, caused quite a bit of damage. And 25-year-old Courtney Mays, who was the shift leader at the time, has been arrested and charged with felony aggravated arson.
Very happy to hear that. Seems like there should be more charges, but all right, I'll take those.
How's that for the education of this country, Cande?
Unbelievable, really.
Scary.
Oh, it's just frightening. What makes people tick.
I'm speechless. I don't even know what to say at that story. I will tell you, today, Cande, is National Mac and Cheese Day.
Ooh, you know, I've been thinking about macaroni and cheese lately.
It's a parent's best friend.
It is. Well, yes, in the box it is.
Yeah. So I will tell you the two best mac and cheeses I've ever had.
Oh, you mean homemade or in a box?
No, at places. At places.
Oh, I've at had, places. Okay.
Well, let me take Barbecue Tom's mac and cheese out of the running because that was fantastic as well. But as far as restaurants or whatever, the two best mac and cheeses I've ever had, the mac and cheese at Chick-fil-A is outstanding.
Never
Cande.
Tried it.
Outstanding.
I'm going to have to try it.
And there is a local joint right on Montauk Highway in Santa Mariches called Atlantic Seafood. And they make, as a side dish on their menu, mac and cheese. It is outstanding, Cande.
That's wonderful. Now, I was at a local diner that we've gone to many times. I think it was a Mother's Day several years ago, and I had lobster macaroni.
Yes.
And it was fabulous.
They make lobster mac and cheese at that seafood place, too.
Mm, it was so good.
Now, Dana will make mac and cheese. And, you know, I tell you,
I make it, too, here and there, but I try not to because I like it so much.
During the week, during the fall and winter, she's probably making mac and cheese twice a week, and then we make extra. We keep it throughout the week.
Of course.
In the summer, not as much, but I'll tell you, in a pinch, the kids, I mean, they eat it all. The white shells, the orange shells, whatever.
It's always good.
Yeah.
Always.
And by the way, Kraft is unveiling today mac and cheese ice cream on their website today.
Yeah, I'm not that interested. I want to chew my mac and cheese, if that's okay.
Yes, I understand.
Do you understand?
I do.
I've also never tried the Velveeta. It's not in a box, but it's sort of in a box. Okay. I wonder how that one is.
Alrighty, I don't know.
Well, why don't you try some today and get back to me?
The kids like the white shells of Annie's. It's called Annie's.
Annie's is very good.
Mm-hmm. Today's also National Nude Day, Cande.
All right, let me take off my pajamas.
Yeah. Have some mac and cheese in the nude, if you will, today.
Yeah, why not? Just don't get burned.
Today is National Grand Marnier Day.
You know, I was looking at a bottle of Grand Marnier in the liquor store yesterday. You know, I bought a portable bar that you can roll around the house for when guests come over. So I'm trying to stock it slowly here and there. So yesterday I purchased a bottle of Frangelica, but I was looking at the orange liqueur. Yes, I was.
All right. I'm going to get back to the Grand Marnier in a second. I could see it now. Brian, roll in the bar. I can't get out of bed.
He had to put it together, which he's never happy about. He said, this is the last time I'm going to put anything together for you that comes in a box with 100 screws and bad instructions. I was grateful he did that, and I think I'm done anyway ordering things of that nature, so we're good.
I think Dana will admit I'm good at putting those things together. Whenever we get something in a box, we've gotten desks, tables, chairs.
Oh, he's good at putting it together. Yeah. He complains the whole time.
I put them together. It takes me, you know, I go very slow. I lay everything out.
Takes him a while, yeah. But he complains the whole way through.
Yeah. I can't believe you have a rolling bar.
A rolling bar. And this will help at my Christmas Eve party when I roll it out into the living room and say, ladies and gentlemen, my bar. Help yourself.
Brian, pour me a fresh screwdriver and roll that thing in here.
Roll the bar out. I don't feel like getting up.
Oh, my. What is Grand Marnier, by the way?
I think it's sort of an orange liqueur, if I'm correct.
Okay.
Frangelica is a hazelnut one, and it's really delicious.
What's the one that people pour in champagnes? It comes in that little...
I know what you're talking about. It's some sort of raspberry, I want to say, berry thing. Some liqueur. I forget the name of it. My neighbor used to do that all the time.
It's very fancy. Looks like English, like the crown kind of thing.
Very fancy.
And today's National Tape Measure Day. Go measure something, Cande.
Hey, I know where my tape measures are. That's all I have to say. In a pinch, you need them. Hey, I had to measure where the rolling bar was going to stay.
We had to measure where the washer and dryer would fit, yes.
Hey, you have to measure things.
Cande, here's a couple of things for you. The owner of a pizza place in Ohio, Heavenly Pizza, held an Employee Appreciation Day. All the money they brought in went to the workers, so each worker ended up making $78 an hour that day.
Ooh, that's good money.
Yeah. A 94-year-old woman in Alabama, Martha Mae Tucker, 94, got to cross something off her bucket list. She got to try on wedding dresses. Now, she got married in 1952, but in 1952, black women were not allowed in the bridal shops, Cande.
It's just shocking to even hear that.
It's incredible. It's incredible. And she told her granddaughter she always wanted to try on a real wedding dress. So they went, they found a place, they did her makeup, they took her to a bridal shop, and she tried on dresses, Cande.
Wow. I love that.
94. Really?
You know, I think I could do that every afternoon if someone would go with me.
You would try on dresses every day.
I could.
I could see it. You could shop every single day.
I could. I think I have a slight addiction.
You would be, this is you. You'd be walking around Tanger. Brian would be following you with the rolling bar.
Now, this is his nightmare, okay? It might be my fantasy, but it's his nightmare.
Brian, I'm heading into Coach to look for a new bag.
Make sure there's ice in that ice bucket when I come out.
I want a very dry martini. Sit on that bench there. Make me a very dry martini. Thank you.
Yeah,
I'll be out
in
a minute.
That's funny.
Cande, enjoy the humidity today, okay?
Oh, you too, my friend. Wear your weather proudly.
Yes, my country, 96.1.
Phathead and Cande in the morning, weekdays 6 to 10 a.m. on my country, 96.1.